Even if you're shooting on an 8K 360 camera, the moment you zoom in on or reframe that footage, it can start looking soft, pixelated, and honestly, pretty unusable. But what if you could actually fix that? Today's video is sponsored by AIArty, and I'm going to show you how their video enhancer can take your footage to the next level. Whether you're upscaling 360 clips, breathing new life into old low-res videos, slowing down regular clips with smooth frame interpolation, or even fixing bad audio, AIArty packs a surprising amount of AI-powered fixes into one tool. Down in my timeline, I've got an 8K 360 clip shot on a DJI Osmo 360. As far as 360 cameras go, this is about as good as it gets. But the moment I reframe this clip for a standard project, I'm instantly losing resolution. That might be fine if you're just posting something quick to social media, but for a professional project, or even mixing this with footage from a regular 4K camera, the quality loss really stands out. If I zoom into 200% in my viewer, you can see how quickly the image starts to fall apart. The good news is, this is exactly where AIArty Video Enhancer comes in. To get started, I need to export this clip out of Final Cut Pro so I can bring it into the Video Enhancer. Here's how I do it. Because I have other clips in my timeline and I only want to export this one, I'll switch to the Range Selection tool and use it to select just this clip. Then I'll hit the Share button and choose Export File. In the export settings, I'll make sure the format is set to video and audio, the codec is Apple ProRes 422, and the resolution matches my project. This keeps as much detail as possible without blowing up the file size unnecessarily. Once that's ready, I'll export the file to my desktop so I can easily drag it right into the Video Enhancer. Once the export's finished, I'll open up AIArty and simply drag and drop my clip into the main window. Within a couple of seconds, I get a side-by-side preview showing my original footage on the left and the enhanced version on the right. I can scrub through the clip to check different frames, and if the clip is too long, I can use the trim handles at the start and end to shorten it. Now, take a look at the car's headlights in my clip. Here's the original, and here's the AIArty preview. The difference is huge. Without adjusting a single setting, this clip already looks exponentially better. From here, I can just leave everything at default and hit Export Current to save my enhanced version. Back in Final Cut Pro, here's a direct comparison between the original clip and the one enhanced with AIArty. Let's take a look at another example, and this time, we'll play around with some of the settings. For this one, I have a clip shot in HD, and I'm going to use AIArty to upscale it for a 4K project. Just like before, the first step is dragging the clip into Video Enhancer. Over on the right-hand side, you'll see a few important options. First, you can choose the hardware used for enhancement, and right below that, the AI model. There's three different models. Mode Detail HQ, which is best for bringing out fine detail and texture. Smooth HQ, which is great for restoring flawed videos while keeping textures and colors consistent. And Super Video HQ, designed for extremely noisy, low light, or dark interior footage. In my experience, if you're not happy with the first result you get, switching to a different model can make a big difference. For this example, I'll go with Smooth HQ. Next, we can set how much to upscale a clip. Since this is an HD clip, and I want to use it in a 4K project, I have a couple options. I can upscale it to 4K, or I can just 2x my resolution. I find I get the best results with this option. Below are a few basic editing and color controls, along with a frame interpolation option, which I'll cover later in this video. For now, I'll hit Export and let AIArty upscale this HD clip to 4K. It does take a bit of time, but the results are worth it. Here's the original HD clip. And here's the same clip, upscaled to 4K. Besides upscaling footage, AIArty Video Enhancer is also a powerful tool for fixing slightly blurry shots. In this next example, my clip is just a little out of focus, and when I zoom in, it becomes really obvious. Normally, this is the kind of shot I'd have to throw away, but with a Video Enhancer, there's a good chance we can salvage it. I'll drop the clip into the Video Enhancer and set the AI model to Super Video HQ. This is the most advanced option. It is designed mainly for grainy, low-light footage, but I found this also does a great job of bringing back detail in soft or blurry shots. The trade-off is that it's the slowest model. You can check the turbo box to speed things up, though you will lose a little quality. For this demo, I'll use Super Video HQ with turbo on and run it on a 5-second clip. I'll fast forward the process here. It took about 2.5 minutes. That might sound like a long time for such a short clip, but look at the results. Here's the original blurry shot. And here's the same clip, enhanced with the AIArty Video Enhancer. The improvement is dramatic and definitely worth the wait. While Super Video HQ works well for bringing back detail in out-of-focus shots, it's really optimized for fixing grainy, low-light footage, like this clip right here. I'll drop it into AIArty, set the AI model to Super Video HQ, and then use the built-in color tools to give it a little extra punch. I'll check the color box, bring up the contrast, and lower the shadow levels to make the fireworks stand out more. With a live preview, you can immediately see the difference. You can view it as a default split screen, or switch to the side-by-side view to compare the same part of your frame before and after enhancement. Now, let's export our clip and take a look. Here's the original low-light footage, and here's the enhanced version with AIArty. The grain is reduced, the colors pop, and the overall shot looks much cleaner. The ability to enhance clips like I showed in my previous examples already makes AIArty Video Enhancer an incredibly valuable tool, but it doesn't stop there. You also get AI-powered frame interpolation, which can generate new frames in your footage for silky smooth slow motion. Let's take a look at this demo clip. A shot like this would look amazing slowed down. The problem is, it wasn't recorded at a high frame rate, so if I just slow it down, it looks choppy and honestly unusable. Let's see if the AIArty Video Enhancer can fix that. I'll take my clip, drop it into the Video Enhancer, set the AI model to Super Video HQ, and this time, check the Frame Interpolation box. From here, I can choose a specific frame rate to convert to, or I can select the slow motion option and slow my clip down to half speed or even 1/4 speed. Let's go with 1/4. I'll export the clip and bring it back into Final Cut Pro for comparison. Here's my original clip. The same clip slowed down to 25%. And here's the exact same clip, enhanced with AIArty and slowed down to 1/4 speed. The difference is night and day, and the motion looks buttery smooth. A tool like the AIArty Video Enhancer is amazing, and honestly, it can be a real lifesaver. It can mean the difference between throwing footage away and completely saving your project. In the right situation, it could even save you thousands of dollars. And the best part is you can get it for a fraction of that. You get two options, an annual license for $79 per year, or what I recommend, a lifetime license for a one-time fee of $165. Pay once, and it's yours forever, with free updates for life. And if my examples were enough to convince you, you can even try it yourself for free. Just check the link in the video description to get started. I really don't think you'll regret it. A huge thank you to AIArty for sponsoring this video and building such a powerful tool. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.